Good day and welcome to The Arena. This is our weekly sports show where we bring you sporting highlights and news that took place at home and abroad. My name is John Colin Namine and we start today's show with some cricket news. Now, the national cricket team is currently on its way to the United Arab Emirates to compete at its first ever T20 World Cup, which starts on the 17th of October. My colleague Helga Schutz attended their farewell function in Windhoek last week, where he spoke to one of the team members there, Piki Yafrans. Let's have a look at that conversation.
I was very honored, privileged, you know, it was finally a dream come true since a young boy. All I've ever wanted, you know, to be selected and compete for Namibia at the highest level, and this is an opportunity. And as you know, very emotional as well, you know, mixed emotions, but it's very honored and proud to be a member of the national team.
Right, and you were out for quite a while, you were injured, and then you came back against the Titans and put in a brilliant bowling spell in the one match, 4 wickets for 9 runs to win the man of the match. So that boosted your confidence.
Yes, definitely, Helga. As you mentioned, I've sustained 2 injuries in the past 8 months, which have kept me out for basically 5 months. So once I recovered, it was important to get game time under my belt. And, you know, after taking those 4 wickets against Titans, my confidence really rose and my performance just steadily started going from strength to strength. Yes.
Right, now what are you aiming for? What's your dream to achieve at the World Cup?
You know, right now as a team, we're trying to take one game at a time. So, you know, we're targeting the first game against Sri Lanka. Hopefully we can cause an upset and, you know, just build from strength to strength and hopefully qualify into the next group stage of the World Cup. And, you know, just try and have fun at the end of the day and make our country proud.
And a message for your fans?
Fans, no, I don't know, just, you know, support us, you know, believe in us, because I think it's important that, you know, us as a country, we come together and, you know, hopefully we can put our country on the map.
Right, good luck.
Thanks, Alda, no problem.
Now, let's shift to some football news. Only 4 teams remain in the hunt for the MTC NFA Cup away trophy after winning the quarterfinal matches in Windhoek and in Tsumeb on Saturday. So, at the SKW Stadium, Blue Waters beat young Brazilians 5-3 on penalties after the teams were level at 2-2 at full time, while young African beat Citizens 2-0. In Tsumeb, at the Oscar Norwich Stadium, Civics beat Kuse Football 3-0, while Mighty Gunners beat Tigers 2-1. Here's a report on all of that, compiled by Helga Schutz.
At the SKW Stadium in Windhoek, Blue Waters seemed to be on course for a comfortable victory against young Brazilians when they took a 2-0 lead by half-time. They opened their account on 30 minutes when Brazilians keeper Charles Uira parried a shot by Hendrik Somaep and wing-back Aprocius Pietras slammed the loose ball into the net. 6 minutes later, they went 2-0 ahead when Somaep was fouled in the box and stepped up himself to beat Uirap from the spot. Brazilians came back attacking after the break and opened their account when Francois Fris pounced onto a loose ball to score from close range. Brazilians kept on attacking but missed several chances before Fris grabbed his second and the equaliser to send the match into penalties. All Blue Waters' players converted their spot kicks, while their keeper Kelvin Spiegel made a fine save to give them a 5-3 victory and passage into the semi-finals. In the late match at SKW, young African beat Citizens 2-0 after a brace by their Ivorian striker Konan Kouame. He opened the scoring after only 2 minutes and made it 2-0 midway through the second half when he stabbed a loose ball into the net. Citizens missed a great opportunity when Lazarus Narusep sent a great cross into the box, but Letu Shatimwene shot wide with an open goal mouth gaping, and their misery was compounded when Narusep was sent off for a foul with 20 minutes to go. In Tsumeb, Mighty Gunners beat Tigers 2-1 through goals by Rakotoka Munoko and Pinias Jacob, while Johannes Jackson replied for Tigers. Civics, meanwhile, beat Kuze Football Club 3-0 after a brace by Dynamo Fredericks and another goal by Ngunzu Salazar.
In more football news, the MTC Hopsol Youth Soccer League is once again in full flow with numerous matches taking place in the capital over the weekend. Now, in the under-12 category, the log leaders SKW were held to a 2-2 draw by Athletic Club Football Academy, who moved up to third position on the log. Once again, my colleague Helge Schütz was there and he spoke to SKW coach Potash Kabwe after the match. Let's take a look at that conversation.
For me, the game was good. You know, when you were with these young players, sometimes you need to, you know, to lead them as a coach. You need to give that voice to the boys so that they always wake up, they always concentrate with the game. But for me, I think it was a good game. It was a good game for me.
And you are now fourth on the log, 2 points behind the leaders. SKW still on top. So do you think you can go far in this league?
Now, for now, I don't want to think about their games. I just want to go to the games. Just every game I'm playing, I'm playing, it's a final. So I just need to collect points, all the games I'm playing. I just want to try my best with my boys. Boys, I don't want to, you know, with these boys, if you put pressure on them, some of them say, yeah, you're not playing well, you're this and stuff, then I need points, I need to win. Sometimes it's not all about winning. Points, sometimes it's all about grooming the boys to want to love, play the game and come back again. So for now, I don't think I want to talk about the race and this and stuff. I just want to keep it easy with the boy. Whatever comes up, maybe later on goes ahead, we are going to play home and away. So maybe second round, the boys can do it. You know, just because of this COVID, you know, the boys were sitting out and it was hard for them. They were not playing football. So like now, we just want to keep them in shape.
Right. And Protest, is there lots of talent in these junior ranks here?
A lot of talent, yeah. But that's what I was wishing if the Premier League coaches here in Namibia, if they come and watch these boys play, you know, they need to catch them young. When they are young like this, that's when you can see the talent. And I'm wishing if they can also take like under 19s to play. Like for Tigers, they need to have 5 players to join their club, under 19 players, like hope so. I think it will help them. You know, it's not going to be hard for the national team coaches to pick up players because you already have the youngsters coming up.
The Rugby Premier League resumed after a 4-month break due to COVID-19 rules and regulations, and Western Suburbs got off to a great start after they thrashed United 82-7 to move up to second position on the log, just behind UNAM. Suburbs managed to score 12 tries while Justin Nell added 11 conversions for a personal tally of 22 points. Now again, my colleague Helge Schütz interviewed Suburbs coach Jackie Bock after the match. Let's have a look at what Bock had to say.
Well, to be honest, it wasn't as good as we actually expected, because there's still a lot of stuff to work on. The score is not a real reflection of the game. The United boys really gave a good run for our money, but the boys stuck to the plans and executed well today.
Right, it's the first game in quite a long break due to COVID. Are you happy with the fitness levels?
So I was actually expecting my team to struggle in the second half, but just somewhere they got more energy. But I think it's when you play on the front foot, it's way better than defending. So I think that's why my guys managed to play for 80 minutes.
Right, and where does this put you on the log, and how do you feel about the rest of the season?
I think now we're second now on the log, just above Grootfontein, with 19, and I think Grootfontein's got 18. So, but the next two games, we just have to pick up the pace, because the last game is against UNAM, and that will be one of the big games for us in the season now.
So what's your aim for the season?
To play finals and win it.
Okay, on to some boxing news. Flames special one Nangolo will top the bill when he takes on Gustav Petrus in a rematch at the NamPower Convention Center on the 9th of October. Now, Nangolo did win their first match on a unanimous points decision. And at a press conference in Windhoek last week, he was full of confidence that he will also win the rematch.
I've been in this game for a while, quite a long time. Since I was 6 years old, I was doing this till today. And I'm just getting on another level, stepping up a bit, facing the better opponents. The problem, the guys, they don't want to fight. That's not going to stop us. We will continue doing what we can do and doing what we know about. Because we know nobody can beat us. Anybody they bring on board, we are going to beat them up. That's the only main thing. I'm 6-0 now, and I'll be 7-0 on 9 October. And I just want to call everybody who is coming through to make it earlier, because this time I don't think it's going to be that long. Because this time I think I'm more prepared. I've got enough time to prepare for this fight. Because I was supposed to fight September, and now I'm fighting in October. And I'm just so ready to beat these kids up. As they all know, he's the new kid on the block. Ain't nobody can beat me. I swear. These boys, they can't do anything to me. They can't even match my skill level. since I was a little kid, I had this with me that nobody can beat me. And for sure, nobody will ever beat me. There's quite a lot of names here in Namibia that are in my division, and they are giving me their back. So we are just waiting on a call. It's just a call away for us to step at your doorstep.
In more boxing news, the first edition of the MTC Salute Boxing Academy's monthly amateur tournament took place at the Aftercare Center in Kommersdal on Saturday. Enoke Kaumba has more on that.
This Saturday saw the first edition of the MTC Salute Boxing Academy's monthly amateur tournament, consisting of amateur boxers from the junior, youth, senior, and female categories. The tournament is aimed at keeping the amateur boxers active every month in preparation for the National Youth Games that will be hosted in Windhoek later this year. Sponsor Killian Kamanya says the tournament can also be used as an opportunity for more amateur boxers to help themselves turn professional.
I come up with the program of the youth every month, them to starting now to if you don't having a youth, you're not having a future boxers. Mm-hmm. We groom them to go to go to becoming a champion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and if you see today, really, it's so nice to see the youth enjoying and really doing a sport.
Mm.
So far now with the tournament, are you happy with what you've seen? Are you satisfied with everything that's happening now?
Yeah, no. So far, so good. So if you can see yourself also, the boy really they are getting there.
Mm-hmm.
They are getting there. You can also take them to the professional now. Mm. Some of them they are ready to go to professional.
Also in action in one of the female categories was Miriam Pretty Assassin Gilongwa. She fought in the light flyweight category against Payange Sheya from Intelligence Boxing Academy from the Ohangwena region. Now on Thursday, a businessman, Ananias Yambo, sponsored her with boxing trunks. Now this is after seeing one of her fights on YouTube. Here's what she had to say after her fight.
The fight was really good. I'm happy. I won. And I gained a bit of experience, even though she was coming, but I just kept on coming also. I kept on pushing her.
So what does this win mean to you moving forward? So you received sponsorship already on Thursday. Now moving forward, this win, what does it mean to you?
This win is very much important for me. Because now, even though I'm invited abroad, I can go.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a free ticket for me.
Okay.
Enoke Kaumba was a busy man as he also spoke to Joel Ngungu, the chairperson of the Commerce Boxing Federation, about the tournament.
Yeah, Salute Boxing Academy is one of our stakeholders. The boxing club that have amateur boxers in Commerce somehow fall under Commerce Boxing Federation. Now, because of COVID and everything, he has a lot of amateur boxers in his stable at all levels, junior, youth, and senior, and they were not fighting. So he called us at his office. We give him our proposal, and he said, I want to do this every month. And we welcome that initiative because we want these guys to fight each and every month. That's how we can prepare them. Yes.
Mm. Okay, good. Also, I saw at the event, you were very strict when it came to rules. When you found out an older boxer wanted to fight against a younger boxer, you were very strict and saying that no, this one you must not box because you are old. And moving forward, how will this affect the tournament moving forward, and what strict measures are you going to put in place to make sure that these things don't come up and people understand the rules and the regulations as accustomed to the federation?
Okay, what happened is that was a category of youth boxers. Youth boxers is from 16 year old to 18. Okay. Now, we are trying to build a team. In December, we have the National Youth Games that are going to be hosted here in Windhoek. So we are the host. So we are trying to build that team for Commerce. Now, if you bring in these older guys, the gentleman you are referring to is 22 years old. And he wanted to fight a 16-year-old boy. So what happened if this boy get beat? Probably will not even come back to boxing anymore. He says it's a bad thing. So we have to manage all these things. Mm. We don't want to chase people. It's just like someone who's starting, you cannot give him an experienced boxer. He will not come back to boxing anymore. Mm. So we are building a team. At the same time, we want to protect these boxers. So the next time when we host another tournament for the youth category, I think at the weigh-in we request for their birth certificate just to be on the safe side. Mm-hmm. Or if a boxer is coming to the weigh-in and he's claiming to be youth, then if he doesn't have his birth certificate, then he cannot. We cannot help.
It's birthday time again, and this week we celebrate Brave Gladiators captain Zenata Coleman, who turned 28 on Saturday. Here's a tribute compiled by my colleague August.
Namibia's most successful female footballer, Zenata Coleman, was born in Kitmanswip on 25 September 1993. She started playing soccer at a young age in the streets of Tseplagte, and her skill and natural talent soon became apparent. She was spotted by national women's coach Jackie Shipanga at the age of 13 and invited to join Premier League side JS Academy. 2 years later, she played for Namibia under 17 at the Ball Games, where she was the top goalscorer, and in 2011 was called up to the national senior team at the age of 17. She soon became their first choice forward, and in 2014 was one of the star players at the Africa Women's Championships and was selected as one of the 5 finalists for the Africa Women Player of the Year award. Coleman's talents took her further afield, and in 2016 she joined the Lithuanian team Gintra University, where she scored an incredible 110 goals in 31 matches and helped them to win the Women's A-League in 2016 and 17, as well as the Baltic Women's League in 2017. In 2018, she joined Spanish Premier League side Zaragoza and represented them for one season, playing 14 matches and scoring 7 goals. The following season, she joined Valencia and went on to play for them for 2 seasons, playing 47 matches and scoring 11 goals. In 2020, she joined Sevilla and is now in her second season with the team, having made 33 appearances and scoring 7 goals. Happy birthday, Zenata, and keep on banging in those goals.
Well, that's all we have for today's show. Catch us again next week, same time, same place. From me, John Colin Amene, and everyone else in studio, it's cheers.